Welcome, my name is Daniel. Welcome to High Grove UMC. Let's continue off with this prayer. May you please stand up. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you for blessing us today, Lord. Thank you for having us today. Thank you for gathering all of us today in a special day and making us wanting us to hear your prayer, Lord, which we're going to say today. Please bless everyone here. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen. Hola, me llamo Gaby. Acompáñenos a alabar a nuestro Señor Jesucristo. I want to say that God has a powerful message for you and your marriage.
Para tu vida.
For you and your life.
En este año que pasó ha sido de muy duro porque la pandemia ha llevado a muchas personas a mejor vida.
I know that this last year has been really tough for many of us and our families due to COVID.
Y quizás hoy ya estás pasando por muchos problemas.
And maybe today you're still going through some problems.
Pero hoy te va a decir el Señor que para que tengas un milagro.
But I want to say that for you to have a miracle first happening in your life.
Tiene que estar pasando algo en tu vida.
You got to be going through something.
Y hoy Dios va a abrir un panorama diferente a la situación que estás viviendo.
And today God is going to open a big panorama for you to see.
Y vas a empezar que lo que tú pensabas que era malo.
And what you think has been bad or negative,
en este momento,
in this very moment,
el Señor va a abrir tu mente,
God will open your eyes
y te va a enseñar
que todo esto es un propósito.
And he's going to show you that what you thought was negative is going to be positive. There's a purpose for that reason.
Así que prepárate para tu milagro.
So prepare for your miracle.
Y no importa lo que esté pasando.
And it doesn't matter what's going on right now.
Estamos hablando de un Dios de cosas imposibles.
We're talking about God of all impossible.
No de cosas suavecitas.
Not of just simple things.
De cosas imposibles.
More of impossible.
Como decir, mi esposo nunca cambia.
Like saying, for example, my husband is never going to change.
O mi esposa.
Or my wife is never
going to change. Mis hijos están perdidos.
My children are so lost.
Mi casa ya la perdí.
My house, I completely lost it.
Déjame decirte que mi Dios.
I'm going to tell you that my God.
Dios de imposibles.
Is a God of impossibilities.
Es un Dios de imposibles.
He's God of impossibilities.
Hay una historia en la Biblia.
There's a story in the Bible.
La historia de Noé.
The story of Noah.
Y la encontramos en Génesis 7:1.
And we find it in Genesis 6:1.
7:1,
I'm sorry.
Dice, dijo luego Jehová a Noé.
And he says, God then said to Noah.
Entra tú y toda tu casa en el arca.
Come in, you and your family, into the ark.
Porque a ti he visto justo delante de mí en esta generación.
Because I've seen you do justice in front of me in this generation.
Si tú estás viendo esto,
if you're watching
la pregunta es, ¿por qué a ti no te dio COVID y pasaste esa mejor vida?
My question is, how come you didn't have or get to get COVID and you're still living your life?
Estuviste cerca de mucha gente contagiada.
You were very close to people that were contagious to it.
A todo el mundo le pasó algo.
Something happened to everybody in the world, but not to you.
Tú estás bien.
So you're fine.
A lo mejor pasas por una agonía.
Maybe you're going through something like a little agony.
¿Por qué no falleciste?
But why didn't you pass away?
Porque Dios tiene un propósito.
Because God has a purpose for you in your life today.
Dios manda a Noé.
God sends Noah.
Es un capítulo muy largo esto.
It's a really long chapter.
Pero me voy a saltar.
But I just want to real quick go through it.
Para lograr avanzar en todo el capítulo.
To be able to advance in the rest of this chapter I'm trying to speak of.
Dios le da una orden a Noé.
God gave an order to Noah.
Una orden.
One order.
En las órdenes no se discute.
And when you're told an order, you don't discuss
them. Solo lo hace.
You're just told to do.
Y Noé fue lo que hizo.
And that's what Noah did.
Le dijo, entra en el arca.
He said, get into the ark, you and your family.
Y él obedeció.
And he obeyed.
En este momento,
in this very moment,
Dios está diciendo,
God is telling him,
entra a la arca.
Come into the ark.
O sea, entra en su presencia.
Come into his presence of God.
Entra en su palabra.
Come into his presence of God.
Ese es el arca.
That's the ark.
Que nos protege.
That is protecting us.
El arca está diseñada de tres partes.
The ark is designed in three different forms.
Pero algo que me llamó mucho la atención.
But something that really grabbed my attention.
Que le manda hacer una ventana.
That he sent him to do a little window.
Usted va donde quiera, donde hay barcos.
Wherever there's boats.
Todos tienen muchas ventanas.
They all have a lot of windows.
Esta arca nomás tiene una sola ventana.
This ark only had one little window.
¿Y en dónde la puso?
And where did they put it?
En lo más alto.
They put it in the highest part.
¿Y sabes por qué?
And you know why?
Porque cuando hay un problema en tu matrimonio.
Because whenever you have a problem in your marriage.
Cuando hay un problema en tu familia.
Whenever you have a problem with
your family. Cuando tienes un problema de salud.
When you have a health problem with yourself.
¿A dónde miras?
Where do you see? What do you see?
Al cielo.
You look up in the sky.
Solo Dios puede hacer el milagro.
Only God can be around.
Solo Dios te puede salvar.
Only God can save you.
Así que si ellos hubieran tenido ventanas,
so if they were to have windows everywhere,
cuando la gente estaba muriendo,
when people were passing away,
cuando los animales estaban
were dying and the animals were being or dying,
eso los hubiera distraído.
That would have distracted them.
Pero con la ventana arriba,
but with the window being attached,
no les quedaba otra más que ver a Dios.
They had nothing else but to look up in the sky and look at God.
Así que no te distraigas.
So don't distract yourself.
Es tiempo de que mires a Dios.
It's time for you to look at God.
Cuando estaba haciendo el arca Noé.
When Noah was doing the ark.
Imagínate, duró 120 años haciendo el arca.
Imagine it took 180 years to create it, to construct it. 120, I'm sorry.
Y bueno, ¿y esto para qué es?
And well, he always thought like, well, why am I building this? What is this for?
Nunca había llovido.
It never rained where he was.
Noé no sabía que era lluvia.
No one never knew that rain was going to come.
Solamente hacía lo que Dios le mandaba.
He just did what God told him to do.
Toda la gente se burlaba de él.
Everybody would be there making fun of him.
Está loco.
Saying, wow, he's crazy.
Lluvia.
Rain.
¿Qué es eso?
Why?
Y se reían.
And they would laugh
y se
at him.
Burlaban.
They would make fun of him.
Y le hacían bully.
And they would bully him.
Y él obedecía a Dios.
And he would just stay there and still obey God.
A lo mejor también su familia se burlaba.
Maybe his family did too make fun of him.
Pero él obedecía.
But he obeyed at God at all times.
No importaba.
It didn't matter.
Él hacía lo que Dios le decía.
He did what he told him to do.
Y empezó a hacer el arca.
And so he started to do the ark.
Como Dios le había dicho o le decía.
God exactly told him to do it.
Pero no lleva timón.
¿Qué?
Volante.
Oh, but it didn't have no wheel.
Curioso, ¿no?
Curious, right?
Está el bote,
you
está
have
el
boat,
arca, pero sin timón.
But with no wheel.
¿Quién va a manejar?
Who's gonna steer?
¿Te subirías a un carro sin volante?
Would you get in a car without a steering wheel?
¿En el freeway?
And just like roll over the freeway.
Imagínate cómo estuvo eso.
Imagine how that was then.
Pero ¿quién iba a manejar el bote entonces?
But who was gonna drive the ark?
Dios.
Jesus was. God was.
Dios iba a manejar.
God was going to drive the ark.
Porque si le puede, le había puesto un volante.
Because if someone was to put a wheel,
no,
a steering wheel,
¿quién sabe dónde hubiera ido a chocar?
Who knew who was going to drive and how are they going to end up?
No hubiera salido vivo ahí.
They probably wouldn't have made it.
Cuando dejas que Dios dirija tu vida.
When you let God lead your life.
Cuando dejas que Dios dirija tu matrimonio.
And you let him lead your marriage.
Cuando dejas que Dios dirija tus hijos.
When you let him lead your children.
Cuando dejas que Dios dirija tu salud.
When you let him lead your health.
Va a estar todo bien.
Everything is gonna be okay.
Si Adán, si Noé hubiera dirigido el bote.
If Noah was to steer
el arca.
When you steer the ark.
Dios no hubiera estado.
God wouldn't have been there.
¿Para qué si él está dirigiendo?
For what? If he is leading.
Que dirija.
Let him lead.
Pero nosotros no sabemos dirigir bien.
But we don't know how to lead.
Entonces deja que el creador del cielo
y la tierra
dirija tu vida.
Lead your life.
Una vez más, deja que el creador del cielo y de la tierra dirija tu vida.
The creator of heavens and earth come and lead your life.
Porque él va a llevar tu matrimonio.
Because he will take your
marriage a otro nivel.
To a whole other level.
Tus hijos a otro nivel.
Your children to a whole other level.
Y vas a decir, pero es que tengo muchos problemas.
You're going to say, well, it's, I have a lot of problems.
Sí.
Yeah, you do.
Eso es Dios.
That's God.
Así es como Dios trabaja.
That's how he works.
¿Cuánto cuesta una bolsa de naranjas?
How much does a bag of orange cost?
¿Cuánto cuesta un vaso de jugo?
And how much does a little cup of orange cost?
¿Y en qué lugar lo vende? ¿En qué lugar se vende?
And in where do you sell it?
En Estados Unidos.
In the US.
Hay un lugar que se llama Beverly Hills.
There's a spot here called Beverly Hills.
Y un jugo cuesta mucho más que en cualquier otro lado, cuesta 10 veces más.
And an organic cup of orange juice will cost way more here than in Beverly Hills than anywhere else.
El costal de naranjas. La bolsa de naranjas.
The bag of oranges itself.
No vale lo que cuesta el jugo de naranja.
It's not near the same value as the cup of pure orange juice.
¿Por qué cuesta más el jugo, el vaso de naranja que
Why
las bolsas, que las
does
naranjas?
The cup have more value than the oranges itself?
Porque las naranjas tuvieron que ser exprimidas, tuvieron que ser cortadas y tuvieron que ser exprimidas.
Because the bag of oranges had to go through a process. They had to be cut, sliced, and then squished to make that cup of orange.
Tuvieron que quitar todo lo de la naranja.
They
las semillas.
They had to take and peel all the oranges, all the seeds, to be able to squish it, right?
Ese jugo
and get the right amount of juice.
Natural.
And that juice had to be straight organic.
Sin basura.
With no trash.
Sin semillas.
With no seeds, everything filtered.
Por eso que cuesta más caro.
That's why it's a little bit more expensive.
Cuando tú estás pasando por una prueba.
When you're going through
tu matrimonio,
a challenge
familia,
in your marriage, family,
está siendo exprimido,
you're being
exprimida.
Squished, you're being crushed.
Tus hijos jóvenes que me estás viendo, tu vida está siendo exprimida.
Your children, the teenagers, the ones that are looking at me right now,
si no,
they're being squished right now.
Y tú no entiendes.
You don't understand.
¿Por qué me pasa esto?
Why does this happen to you?
Porque Dios está exprimiendo.
But it's because because God is
está sacando lo mejor de ti. Está sacando lo mejor de tu matrimonio.
He's taking the best out of your marriage.
Mi matrimonio es aburrido.
Sometimes you'll say, oh, my marriage is so boring.
Siempre lo mismo.
It's always the same.
Mueres en el mismo lugar.
Even the furniture is the same.
Todo es lo mismo.
Everything's the same.
Pues tienes que pasar por una situación.
That's why you have to go through a
challenge.
Where you have to be squeezed.
Porque tienes que sacar Dios lo mejor.
Because God has to be able to
lo
take out the
bueno.
Best out of you. The good out of you.
¿Sabes dónde estaba el arca cuando pasó esto?
Do you know where the ark was at? When
estaba
this
en el piso.
It was in the floor. On land.
¿Y qué, cómo llegó a la montaña?
And how did it end up in the mountain?
El agua la subió a la montaña.
The water was so powerful and high enough that it took it to the mountain.
El agua subió la
the water lifted the ark.
Y quedó ahí.
And it stayed there. Up in the
comenzamos
mountain.
De abajo.
They started from the bottom.
Para después quedar arriba.
To at the end end up from the top.
En el versículo 4.
In verse Genesis 7:4.
Dice porque pasando aún 7 días.
It says because after 7 days pass.
Dice el Señor, yo haré llover sobre la tierra.
God said I will let it rain over the land.
40 días y 40 noches.
40 days and 40 nights.
Y haré que el agua suba en la faz de la tierra.
And I will let the waters lift up to the land.
Aquí Dios está diciendo a 40, el otro número 40.
God is saying, he's using the number 40.
40 y el número 7 son números perfectos.
The number 40 and the 7.
O sea que todo lo que tú vas a pasar o estás pasando.
Which is perfect numbers and so it is what you're going through.
Todo es perfecto.
Everything is perfect that you're doing.
Son las cosas en realidad no son lo que está pasando.
Everything in reality isn't just what's occurring.
La cosa está pasando lo que tú mires, lo que tú crees.
It's occurring how you're seeing and how you want to believe.
Eso es realmente lo que está pasando.
That's really what's happening.
Así que en estos tiempos hace más de 2000 años atrás.
And so in these tough times, 2000 years ago,
Jesús fue crucificado.
God was crucified.
Llevando todas tus enfermedades.
Taking all of your sicknesses.
Llevando todas tus cargas.
Taking all of your heaviness.
En la cruz del Calvario.
Taking it all the way to the cross.
Asesinado.
And he was assassinated.
Por ti, por mí,
for you, for me.
Por tu matrimonio,
for your marriage.
Por tus hijos,
for your children.
Por tu economía,
for your economy.
Por eso fue crucificado, Jesús.
That's why he was crucified.
Por eso Jesús derramó su sangre.
That's why he shed
para
his blood.
Que tú no pasara lo que
just
está
so
pasando.
That you wouldn't go through what he's going through.
Así que lo que está pasando,
so whatever is happening
crezcas,
right now, it's because you're doing it, you're creating it. And it's for you to mature.
Para que tú aprecies.
It's for you to appreciate.
Primeramente, quién eres tú.
First, who you are.
Tú eres una persona única.
You're a unique person.
Y eres tan única, si quieres pregúntale al FBI.
And you're so unique, you could even ask them.
Nadie tiene las huellas digitales
no
igual que tú.
No one will literally find your fingerprint.
Nadie.
Nobody will match.
Eres único.
You're just
eres
unique.
Única.
You are unique.
Tu matrimonio es único.
Your marriage
tus
is unique.
Hijos son
your
únicos.
Children are unique.
Tú eres único.
You're unique.
Porque Dios te hizo así.
Because God made you like
this. Es tiempo de que empieces a amarte.
It's time for you to love yourself.
Es tiempo de que empieces a trabajar en ti.
It's time for you to work on yourself.
Para que después tú puedas trabajar con tu prójimo.
So that later then you could pass it on.
¿Y sabes quién es tu prójimo?
And you know who you're going to pass it on to?
Tu prójimo es...
Your prodigy?
Tu próximo, que sigue.
Is
próximo.
The next one.
¿Sabes quién es tu próximo?
You know who the next one is?
Tu pareja.
Your married partner.
Tu esposo.
Your wife, your husband.
Tu esposa.
Your wife.
Eso es lo que dice el Señor.
That's what God is saying.
Para que tú puedas amar a Dios.
So that for you to love yourself.
Tienes que amar a tu prójimo.
You also have to love your
tu prójimo.
And your next one.
Ni creas que son los vecinos.
Don't think it's the neighbors.
Ni creas que es la persona que te hizo daño.
Don't think it's the person that did you like harm you.
Tu próximo.
The next one.
Tu pareja.
Is your partner.
Yes. Nadie más.
That's all.
Curioso.
Curious.
Ni siquiera tus hijos.
Not even your children.
Ni siquiera tu mamá.
Not even your mom.
Ni tus hermanos.
Or your brothers.
Tu pareja.
Your partner.
Tu prójimo.
Your next one. Your
cuando
partner.
Tú amas a tu prójimo.
When you love your partner.
Y realmente lo amas.
And you really, really, really love.
No lo quieres.
You don't
no
like
te enamoras.
You know, in love.
Lo amas.
You love.
Porque el amor es algo subnegado.
That's something legal you're saying.
Quiere decir es algo donde tú te niegas.
It's something where you're.
Lo aceptas.
You're accepting.
Lo amas.
You're loving it.
Y te niegas tú. Tú te niegas.
You're not denying.
Por esa persona.
For that person.
Es algo que no puedes entender.
Something that you can't understand.
Por ejemplo, tu hijo, tú lo amas.
For example, you love your husband.
Te robó dinero.
He robbed from you.
Te traicionó.
He betrayed you.
Te maltrata.
He mistreated you.
Y lo sigues amando.
And you still love him.
Y tú no entiendes.
And you don't understand why.
Le das todo.
You give him everything.
Y él es así.
And he's still like that.
Eso es amor funeral.
That's
te niegas.
Funeral love.
Y llamas.
You're denying it, but you love it.
Entonces cuando eso pasa con tu padre.
So when that happens with your partner.
Con
your prodigy.
Con tu esposa, con tu esposo, con tu prójimo.
With your wife, husband.
Las cosas son diferentes.
Things are very different.
Porque cuando los dos se ponen de acuerdo.
Because when they both compromise.
Tu matrimonio camina bien.
Your marriage walks smooth.
Tus hijos van a estar bien.
Your children are going to be okay.
Tus vecinos van a estar bien.
Your neighbors are going to be okay.
Tu país va a estar bien.
Your city is going to be okay.
Porque tú estás bien.
Because you're okay with your partner.
Dios no se equivoca cuando.
And God doesn't get confused.
Nos pone algo muy sencillito.
He puts it very simple.
¿Me amas?
You love me?
Ama a tu pareja.
You gotta love your partner.
Ama a tu prójimo.
I love your partner.
Como te amas tú.
How you love yourself.
Si tú logras hacer eso,
and if you are succeeding,
que es algo que disfrutas,
something that you're enjoying,
es algo que tocas,
something that you touch,
es algo tuyo,
something yours,
si logras hacer eso,
if you succeed in that,
puedes amar a Dios.
You can love God.
Porque a Dios no lo puedes ver.
Because God, you cannot
no
see
lo
him.
Puedes tocar.
You can't touch
no
him.
Lo puedes sentir.
You can't feel him.
Pero a tu prójimo sí.
But to your prodigy, you can.
Ojalá que esto haya sido bendición.
I hope this has been a big blessing for you guys.
Ponle un like.
Please like and share.
Y nos vemos en la segunda.
And we'll see each other.
Pero antes de eso, vamos a orar.
We'll see each other next week, but before we end, let's end with a prayer.
Algo que tiene algo principal.
Something very principal.
Tienes que invitar a quien va a manejar tu bote.
You have to be. ¿Quieres qué?
Manejar tu.
You have to be able to drive your own ark. So you have to be able to steer your own wheel.
Tú eres el arca.
You're the ark.
Y en ti están todas las bendiciones.
And in you there's a lot of blessings.
¿Quieres manejar tú?
Do you want to drive?
¿O quieres manejar? ¿O quieres que o dejar que Dios maneje?
Or do you want to let God drive?
Este momento levanta tu mano derecha.
In this very moment, Ryan, please raise your right hand.
Y dile a Jesús que entre en tu corazón.
And tell God to let himself in you.
Te ayudo, repite conmigo.
I'm gonna repeat.
Señor Jesús.
Dear Jesus.
En esta hora.
In this very hour,
escriba mi nombre,
write my name
en el libro de la vida,
in the book of life.
Cámbiame,
change me,
transformame,
transform me,
entre en mí,
come
entre
in me,
y hágame diferente,
and make me different.
Me arrepiento,
I repent,
de todos mis pecados,
from all my sins,
malos pensamientos,
from my bad
malas
thoughts,
decisiones,
from my bad decisions.
Y ahora le pido que me perdone,
and I ask you to forgive me,
me haga diferente,
make me different.
Y bendiga a mi familia.
And bless my family.
Bendiga lo que yo hago.
Bless what I do.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus, we say.
Amén.
Amen.
Te felicito.
I congratulate you.
No hay cosa mejor en tu vida que hayas hecho.
There is not one better thing that you just did.
Acabas de decir a Dios.
Because you have just finished telling God.
Maneja mi vida.
To basically.
Maneja mi matrimonio.
Lead your steering wheel. Lead your marriage.
Maneja mis hijos.
Lead your children.
Maneja mi economía.
Lead your economy.
Maneja mi salud.
Lead your health.
Todo va a estar bien.
Everything is going to
be. Bendiciones.
Blessings. Thank you guys for watching.